Dear friends, welcome to Dr. Ved channel and to the lecture on babesiosis part 3. In this slide, we will study clinical findings and clinical pathology of babesiosis. Babesiosis is a protozoal disease, very important disease. I am Dr. P.R. Patel, Professor Head, Veterinary Medicine. Here we will see the clinical findings of babesiosis, and babesiosis generally produce, and most of the cases have a very characteristic symptoms, so clinician cannot miss a diagnosis. Incubation period is 2 to 3 weeks. In some books it is mentioned as 5 to 10 days. There are various gradations of clinical signs, right from subacute, acute, peracute, chronic, subclinical cases. So first we talk about the advanced stages, very severe cases. Clinician has observed a severe anemia, hemoglobinuria, and that imparts dark red to brown urine color with a very stable growth. This is the characteristic. Another important symptom, jaundice. And in peracute case, death occur after 24 hours. In acute cases, the similar symptoms are observed. It is also characterized by severe hemolysis, leads to anemia, circulatory disorder, and death in some cases within 1 or 2 days. In babesiosis, fever is the first clinical sign. Along with fever, there is anemia, shock, and a release of large quantities of hemoglobin into the circulation. The condition is called as hemoglobinemia. That is because of the lysis of RBC by multiplication of the organism. The other uncommon symptoms are observed, as with the other disease, the same. Depression, loss of appetite, anorexia, brick red conjunctiva, suggest septicemic condition and congestion, which soon become anemic, weakness, cessation of rumination, salivation, dryness of muzzle, lacrimation, and dropped milk intake. These are the symptoms are observed with the other acute disease also. In continuation of clinical findings, there is a profound diarrhea followed by constipation. Clinician observe the mucous membrane. There is a paleness of eye and gum mucous membrane due to anemia. Jaundice due to bile pigment in the circulation due to metabolism of hemoglobin. Red colored urine because of hemoglobinuria. Appearance of hemoglobin in the urea, and pregnant animals often abort. The clinician observes something characteristic of this disease. There is a spasm of anal sphincter muscles, and that cause a passage of a characteristic feces, a pipe stem feces. What is this pipe stem feces? Here the feces are evacuated with great force. Animal has to make force. And the characteristic of feces is in a long thin stream. That is just like a pipe stem. So it is called as pipe stem feces. Evaluation of clinical findings. Some of the cases shows characteristic nervous symptoms. That is called as cerebral form of babesiosis. That is because of sludging of parasitized RBC in the brain capillary. The parasitized RBC stick to the capillary of the brain. When more RBCs attach to the capillaries of the brain, there is clogging or blocking of the capillaries, and due to block, it leads to ischemia or degeneration or necrosis. And these produce a nervous sign in severe cases. In this cerebral form of babesiosis or nervous form of babesiosis, the symptoms are pertaining to central nervous system, in coordination of movement, there is mania, means mad-like behavior. There are convulsions, posterior leg paralysis. So initially there is excitement. Finally there is depression, paralysis, coma, fever, and death within 12 to 36 hours after the onset of clinical signs. So this cerebral form of babesiosis is comparatively danger form. Generally in cattle and buffalo, the babesiosis infection can range from a very severe acute disease, means paracute disease, that the animal die within 1 or 2 days. Sometime animal may not show symptom, death without pre-monitoring symptoms, to a wide range, to a very less severe cases, in which the fever of about a week and the animal remains sick for about 2 to 3 weeks, or for some time longer. There is a slow recovery, and the infected remain a carrier for a long time. So subclinical form is also observed. Continuation of the clinical finding. We have seen that clinical forms vary from paracute, acute, subacute, chronic, and clinically inapparent subclinical form also. This inapparent subclinical form is common in young animals, and the recovered animals become a latent carrier for a variable periods, for a long time. The chronic cases extend for several weeks with one symptom, and that is intermittent temperature. There is fever, again animal become normal, again fever, animal become normal. So it will continue for a long time. Those survivor can take 3 weeks to complete cure. In this disease, babesiosis, the recovered animal shows a long-lasting immunity. We have already seen that there are chances of pre-immunity. So when there is again infection, they are not infected. That pre-immunity. Cross-immunity between the two organisms is very limited. We have seen the symptoms of bovine babesiosis that also occurs in sheep and goat also. The similar symptoms are also observed in dog and horse also. But in dog, something different is observed. In dog, there are two forms. One is complicated, other is uncomplicated. The name itself says complicated means it causes complication. Uncomplicated means complications are not there. In complicated cases, generally occur due to hemolysis, renal failure occur because the large molecule of hemoglobin block the tubules, block the Bowman's capsule, so there is renal failure. Nervous signs, you want to know that the parasitized RBC clog the brain capillaries, they block the brain capillaries. There is jaundice, anemia, hepatopathy, and cardiac involvement. So symptoms are nearly same as that of bovine babesiosis. In uncomplicated form, it is a very severe form. There is moderate to mild disease and symptoms accordingly. It is also due to hemolysis. The symptoms are characteristic: fever, paler of the mucous membrane, enlargement of spleen. But here the complications are comparatively less. The clinician observed five forms of disease in a dog. And in these various five forms, there are a little bit different symptoms are observed. In this table, we have mentioned five forms. One is the elementary form. The main symptoms are stomatitis, gastritis, and enteritis symptoms. Respiratory form, there is respiratory dyspnea and coughing. In muscular form, there is profound muscle weakness. In circulatory form, the generalized edema all over the body is observed. In ocular form, there is keratitis, iritis, and sometimes the cornea become white. So these are the various forms are observed at various places by the clinician. Here we will see clinical findings in horse. Almost a similar symptom as that of bovine is also found. But here in horse, jaundice is common finding. And so the synonym as biliary fever. Fever is also there. But because of jaundice, name is given biliary. In horse, hemoglobinuria is comparatively rare or almost nil. So these are the two characteristics in horses. Other the symptoms of that is observed in ruminants are also here. Clinical pathology. Severe anemia is the characteristic. And the blood examination suggests severe reduction of packed cell volume, profound decrease in red blood cell count, and decreased hemoglobin is observed. there is increased leukocytes and a moderate neutrophilia. The blood shows increased glucose, bilirubin, and SGOT. Urine examination shows presence of albumin, that is because of hemoglobin. Presence of bile pigment again, that is because of hemoglobin. And hemoglobinuria is also because of the appearance of hemoglobin in the urine. Friends, share this information and video to other veterinarians. Requested to subscribe this channel, to support and to promote channel. Thank you very much for observing this video. Next time, I will come with Babesiosis Part 4. Thanks.